नमः सर्वेभ्य अद्वैतचिन्तनवर्गे सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं पादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ नमः परमऋषिभ्यो नमः परमऋषिभ्यः। चांद्री भगिनि, शान्तिमन्त्रम् एवं प्रथमं श्लोकम् यू कैन हियर नो मी।
यस महोदय।
ओके शोभा भगिनी, कैन यू चैंट दिस शांति मंत्र में इंद्र प्रदम प्रदम श्लोक।
अस्तु। सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीहरिं परमानन्दम् उपदेष्टारमीश्वरम् व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहम्। ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम्।
धन्यवाद भगिनि। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैड ए विचारा प्रोसेस विच वाज एज पर द श्लोका गिवन हियर। कोहम कह अहम कथम इदम जातम कह वै कर्ता अस्य विद्यते उपस्थानम किम अस्ति इह ईत विचारा सोयम ईदृश। ओके नाउ बिफोर आई गो टू द नेक्स्ट श्लोका आई होप ऑल ऑफ अस हैव हैड इनफ टाइम टू do the vichara on this shloka. So anybody wanting some clarification or some additional inputs in this one before we go to the next one? Okay, since there are no questions on this, we'll proceed to the next shloka. Vamshi Bhagini, can you read the shloka in the Deepika?
Yes, Mahodaya. Prayatnam karam. Naham bhuta gano deho naham cha अक्षगणस्तथा एतद्विलक्षणः कश्चिद्विचारः सः अयमीदृशः। ननु चैतन्यविशिष्टः कायं पुरुषः इति बार्हस्पत्य सूत्रादेहाकारण व्हाट्स दिस महोदय बार्हस्पत्य सूत्रादेह कारणेन परिणता
सूत्रात् देह सो दैट इज व्हाई द दत्त प्लस द कार सूत्रात् देह कारणे कारणे
हाँ हाँ सॉरी महोदय, बारहस्पत्य सूत्राद् देहा कारणेन परिणतानि पृथिव्यादि चत्वारि भूतानि भूतान्येवात्मेति भूतान्येवात्मेति चार्वाका वदन्ति सह एव कर्ता सुखीत्यादि सर्वव्यवहार मूलमिति सर्वजन प्रसिद्धौ सत्यात्म विषयो विचारो न स्याद् इत्यत आह नाहमिति अहम् हंश हंश
अहम् अहम्
अहम् ओ अहम् अहम् शब्द प्रत्यालम्बनः प्रत्यगात्मा भूतगणो यो देहः स न भवामि तस्य घटादि वदृश्यात्मादित्यर्थः तर्हि इन्द्रियगणस्त्वं स्या इति चार्वाक एकदेश
सीमित उत्थाप्य
ओ क्षम्यतां महोदय हाँ चार्वाक एक हाँ एकदेशी मत हाँ एकदेशी मत उत्थाय दूषयति उत्ताप्य दूषयति नाहम इति च पुनर्क्षणगणः पुनः अक्षगणः ओ अस्तु आई हैव श्रोत्रादीम् इन्द्रियसङ्घातोऽपि अहम् न भवामि तथेति पदेन देहवदीन्द्रियगणस्यापि भूतविकारस्त्वं दर्शितं स वा एष पुरुषोन्नरसमयः अन्नमयं हि सोम्य मन आपमयः प्राणस्तेजोमयी वाक् इत्यादि श्रुतिरुभ्य अत्र प्रमाणं ननु यदि देहद्वयं त्वं नासि तर्हि न असि तर्हि शून्यमेव स्यादित्या शून्यमेव स्यादित्या शङ्क्याः
शून्यमेव स्यात्
स्यात् इत्या शङ्क्याः
शङ्क्या आह
ओ अस्तु शून्यमेव अस्य इत्यादि शङ्क आह एतद्विलक्षणः एताभ्याम् स्थूल सूक्ष्म देहाभ्याम विपरीत धर्म कह अस्मि अस्थूल मन मनन
व्य अस्थूल मननु अस्थुस्वम
मननु ओ अस्थूल
मन अस्थूलम अननु अहृस्वम
अननु ओ अस्तु क्षम्यतां अस्थूलम अननु ह्रस्वम सम्यक् वा महोदय तत्र
अस्थूलम् अननु ह्रस्वम् अस्थूलम् अननु अह्रस्वम्
अह्रस्वम् इत्यादि श्रुतेः ऐ कान्ट् सी द अदर् पदं महोदय ऐ एम् गेटिङ्ग् द ब्लाकेज्
कश्चित् इति जात्यादि
हा अजात्यादि रहितत्वान् रहितत्वान् मनोवाच वात्
रहितत्वात् मनोमय
रतिहित्वात् मनोवाचाम अगोचरत्वं सम्यक् वा महोदय
मनोवाचाम
गोचरत्वं दर्शितं अयम ईदृशः सविचार इति देयर आल्सो आई कैन नॉट सी व्याख्यानम वा
व्याख्यातार्थ श्रुतेः सुतरता
दैट पादः आई डोंट सी द वर्ड दैट इज बीइंग कवर्ड हियर पादः
श्लोक चतुष्टयम् अपि
बोधव्यः अस्तु इट्स अ लॉन्ग एक्सप्लेनेशन महोदय
ओके I will break it and read it after the Padachheda and Anvaya.
Astu Mahodaya. Dhanyavada.
You can complete the Padachheda and Anvaya of the shloka.
You want me to read it, Mahodaya?
Yeah. Yes, please.
Padachheda na aham bhuta ganaha dehaha na aham cha aksha ganaha tatha etat vilakshanaha kaschid vicharaha saha ayam idrushaha anvayaha aham na bhuta ganaha न देहः तथा च अहम् न अक्षगणः कश्चित् सोम एतत् विलक्षणः सोयम् सोम दैट्स व्हाट आई वाज वंडरिंग एतत् विलक्षणः ईदृशः विचारः Neither am I the group of the created elements and its gross bodies, nor I am the assemblage of subtle sense organs, but different from them without any attributions. Such inquiry is called vicharaha. Astu mahodaya, dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha. Na aham bhuta ganaha. Now, bhuta means creation. Bhuta ganaha means elements of creation. No, panchabhutas, no? Akashad, vayu, vayu, ragni, agne, rapaha, adbhak, prithivya, aushadaya, aushadevya, annyam, annat, purushaha. So this is how the Taittiriya Upanishad and Shruti is mentioning about the bhutagana, how the different ganas or different created materials are combining one after the other. Neither of them aham, asmi, na aham, na dehaha. A deha is annamaya purushaha iti ukte. When the Shruti says that purushonna rasamayaha, annamaya purushaha iti, these are the words used in the Shruti to say that deha is made out of annamaya. So from that point of view, na aham deha, because deha is of the bhutagana. Na aham cha akshagana tata, gashanaha tata. Akshagana means sense organ. If I am not the body, then am I the sense organ through which I am getting the senses of the world outside? I am neither the akshaganaha. Etat vilakshanaha, different from that, kaschit vichaha. कश्चित् विचारः सोऽहम् सोऽयम् सो आई एम नाइदर द बोधगणा नॉर द अक्षगणा बट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दम इज व्हाट शुड बी द थॉट प्रोसेस दिस इज कंटिन्यूएशन फ्रॉम व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास यू नो द एलिमिनेशन प्रोसेस नेति नेति व्हेन यू से आई एम नॉट दिस सो यू आर removing all the bhutaganas one by one, neither the prithivi nor am I made of the earth nor the water nor the fire nor the vayu nor the akasha. So once the bhutaganas are removed, whether then the sense organs are there. Am I the sense organs? Because I am sensing the world through the sense organs. So am I the sense organs or the control or the one is a combination of all the gunas. Chandani Bhagini, I think
yes.
They are not muted. I think. Okay. So what happens is that when there are set of people in those days who were in the introspection and trying to find out who am I, koham, katamitam jatam, this in the earlier thing. So they thought, mistook, even I'm not the body, because body is going through the change of birth, death and decay, that shat vikara. So they thought, if I am not the body, then I must be the indriya gana. Sangadam parathatvad, there is a Mimamsika rule, the sangadam parathat. the combination of many things are for somebody else. That is, suppose if a carpenter or somebody is making a house, he is making an assemblage of different things like the bricks, the cement, the mortar, the roof, the bricks or the, you know, roofing, everything. But he is not making it for himself. He is making it for somebody else. So there is a nyaya in the Mimamsaka, sangadam parartatva. So for the benefit of somebody else is all the sangata. So if I am not the deha, the akshagana, the sense organs are for me, so I am the you know, akshagana, combined effect of all the akshaganas. But then vilakshanaha, I am not the akshagana individually per se also. When I am not saying the body, neither can I claim I am the indriyas. Because each indriya per itself can have growth or decay or anything, but I myself is never getting diminished. So, etat vilakshanaha, these type of thoughts should be the one which will be required helping us to find out who am I. Nanu chaitanya vishishta kaya purushaha iti bahaspatya sutrat deha karena viparinitani prativyati chatvari bhutani eva atmeti. So in the Bahaspati Sutram, Deha is an assemblage or made out of the Prithivyadi Chatvari Bhutani. Because Akasha was not considered in that Bahaspati Sutram. So Vayu, Agni, Apaha, Prithivi is Chatvari Bhutani. Parinitani. From the admixture of all these four things is the cause for my deha. Then comes the charvata, charvaka, who is charuvak. Charuvak means pleasant to hear. What the words which are pleasant to hear, because everybody likes to hear the saying that they themselves are the, eat here, merry, make merry, and you one day you'll live. So why to think about Atma and all those things? You just leave. This body is inert for enjoyment. It says, so boga ayudam, boga yatanam is what they charvaga vatanti. Sa eva karta sukityadi sarva vyavahara moolam iti sarva jana prasiddhau satyam atma visheha. So what they say is that sukha, dukkha, ityadi, vyavahara, and that sarvajana prasiddha, it's common to everyone. So nobody can doubt that it is not true. The charvaga say vatanti, that is the satyatma vishaya, that is that way in which it has been, if that is the case, na syat iti aha, na aham iti, that is not aham. Aham aham shabda pratyalambana pratyagatma bhuta ganaha ya deha sa na bhavami. If I am saying aham aham iti shabda pratyalambam, if I am using the word aham aham and pratyagatma, if I am the innermost awareness which is even knowing the bhuta gana and ya deha sa na bhavami, I cannot be that. Tasya gadativat drishyatvat. The reason why you see, like a gada, which is different from me, it is perceivable or it is an objectifiable product. So the object cannot be the subject. Same way, the indriya gana, that also charvagasya ekadesham is deshi matam. So that is what the charvaga matam is called, ekadeshi matam. Uttapya dushayati naham iticha. So that also is being refuted by saying, when the charvaga says I am indriya gana, just enjoy, make life, and you are the bhogayatanam asti badeham, and you are nothing but a bhogayatanam. There is no atma separate from the deha, is what charvaga says. Puna akshagana shrotradi indriya sanghadha apya atyaham na bhavami tateti padena
देह इंद्रिय गणस्य अपि भूत विकारत्वं दर्शितम्. सो हियर द अक्षगण श्रोत्रादि संघात, एज आई टोल्ड यू नो, संघातम परार्थत्वात्. सो दैट रीजन इज दैट भूत विकारत्वं दर्शयति. सो द मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स आर बीइंग एक्सप्लेन्ड इन दैट प्रोसेस वेयर इंद्रियादि संघातम इज यू नो देयर राइट आईज आर तैजसम, श्रोत्रम इज वायव्य, लाइक दैट दे हैव identified that each indriya is a parivartanam or parinama, or and based on that indriya devatas are or the panchabhutas. And in the shruti it is saying sava yesha purusha anna rasamayaha annamayam hi soumya manaha. So purusha anna rasamayaha, because if they are saying that annam is the reason by which the purusha is growing from a childhood to the old age. So it is what he is being made out of is only the food, and because of that he should be called annamaya. Annamayam hi saumya manaha. So in that the guru says to the saumya, the guru shishya, annamayam hi saumya manaha. So the same manas which we are having is due to annamaya. Now for proving that, there is a story in the Brihada Chandogya Upanishad where Uddalaka says his son, you stop eating food except water and come to me after the 16th day. And after the 16th day, when the boy comes to the father without taking a single morsel of solid food, the son is asked to chant the Veda, Rig Veda. So the son says, I don't remember the Vedas now. I mean, I'm not able to chant the Veda exactly the way in which I used to sing early. So the father says, annamayam is the reason by which your mind was being, withheld from decaying. So when you stop taking annamaya, the mind has started diminishing in its essence. So annamayaha annamayam hi saumya manaha apamaya prano tejo mayi vak. Apamaya pranamaya tejo mayi vak. So vak, the vakendriyam, not the tongue, but the organ, the indriya of speech, is from apamaya, pranamaya, tejomaya. It's a combination of water, air and fire. All these three combined is in the vak. Ityadi shruti bhi shruti ubayatra pramanam nanu yadi deha dvayam tvam nahi tarhi. So from this you are able to identify that even the pramana says annamaya purushaha, the purusha is seen by the individual pratyagatma. So natvam dehamaya dehadvayam tarhi, if that is not the case, shunyameva syat iti ashankya aha edaditi tat etat vilakshanah. So if I am not the annamaya or the guna gana the elements, nor I am the sense organs, then the doubt will come, then am I shunya without anything, nothing like that? Then it says, no, tad vilakshanaha. You are vilakshanaha. Etabhyam stula sushma dehadibhyam viparita dharmas kakosmi. For that, the shruti says, astulam ananu ahrasvam ityadi shruti. The shruti says, you are not stulam, astulam, you are not gross, because the elements are all gross. Ananu is the opposite of stulam. You are neither the anu. Anu is used by the tarkikas. The anu is the smallest of the elements which is in the form as elements. So then dvigunam, trigunam, like that they say that is combination of anus is the reason why gross bodies come up. So astulam ananu. Akhrasvam means the not which is measurable by length or the short. So this is a way of describing Atma Tattvam or Brahma. Astulam ananam ahrusvam ityadi shrutehe kaschititi jatyadi rahitattvam manovachama gocharattvam darshitam ayam idrsha savicharaha iti. So without any jati, varna, all any of those qualifications which is added to the external body, because astulam iti itve jatyadi rahitattvam. Manovachama gocharattvam, neither you are in the anu form because of it, they think that the mana watches, mana walks, and ati is very subtle body, so it is working with neither it is gross nor the subtle body. Darsitam I am idrisasa vicharaha iti vyakhyartha shrute shrutar vyakhyartha cha चतुर्थ पादः श्लोकं चतुष्टयम् अपि बोधव्यम्. नाउ इन दीस फोर श्लोकास विच इज द सेकंड वन इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू. इन दीस फोर श्लोकास दीस आर ऑल बीइंग एक्सप्लेन्ड इन टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वी आर नाइदर द ग्रॉस बॉडी नॉर द माइंड नॉर द यू नो व्हाट द चार्वाका थिंग्स एज द जस्ट as an object which is meant for enjoyment of life only. So this is the second sloka about it. Now comes the third sloka of the group of four slokas for the vichara. Vijaya Bhagini, can you read the sloka?
Ji, charvaka matam advaidi na kim uktam chet kavo pivo maja karo. Kalu ji?
Right. Yeah, bhogayat, they call it as bhogayatanam.
Kava pivo maja karo. Astu ji. Anyanat prabhavam sarvam jnanena praviliyate sankalpo vividaha karta vicharaha so ayam nidrushaha. Tadeva तदेव को अहम एतत् निश्चित्य इदानीं कथमिदं जातमित्यस्य निश्चयः क्रियते तत्र पृथ्वीयादि भूतानि कार्यत्वात् स्वस्व परमाणुभ्यौ जायते इति तार्किकादयः मन्यते कर्मणः जायते इति मीमांसकाः प्रदानात् एव इति संख्याः तत् एतत् निराकुर्वन् आह अज्ञानेन इति इति सर्वं जगतिदं नामरूपात्मकं अज्ञानप्रभवम् अज्ञानात् पूर्वोक्त स्वस्वरूपास्फुराणात् प्रभवति तथा विदम् अत एव एत विरोधिना ज्ञानेन स्वस्वरूप स्फुरणेन तम् इव प्रकाशन् प्रवीलियते निःशेषलीनम् भवति इति अर्थः कः वै कर्तेत्यस्य निर्णयम् आह संकल्प इति विविधः नानाप्रकारः संकल्पः इदं करिष्यामि इत्यादि लक्षणे लक्षणोर्थः
लक्षण लक्षण उतः
लक्षण लक्षण उतः करण परिमाण करण परिणामः कारण अनुकूल व्यापारवान का शेषम पूर्वम उक्तम
अत्र अन्वयम् अपरचेतम् अपि पठतु भगिनी विद्या भगिनी
अहं पठामि पठन् अस्मि अस्तु पदच्छेदः अज्ञानात् प्रभवं सर्वं ज्ञानेन प्रविलीयते संकल्पः विविधः कर्ता विचारः सो अयम् कुत्र अस्ति संकल्पः विविधः कर्ता विचारः सो अयम् ईदृशः अन्वयं सर्वम् अज्ञानात् प्रभवं तत् ज्ञानेन एव प्रविलीयते विविधः संकल्पौ कर्ता सो अयम् Everything is a resulted of misconception that can only be resolved by correct knowledge. There should be inquiries like various ideations are of the doer, one who is not knowing the reality and is a result of imaginations.
Right. Dhanyavaadam. Ajnanat prabhavam sarvam. So from the ajnana, prabhava means udbhavam. So from the ajnana, udbhavati sarvam. Jnanena priviliyate. So the antidote for ajnana is jnana. If the udbhavan takes from ajnana, jnanena priviliyate. Sankalpaha vividha karta vichara svayam is. All these are vividha sankalpaha. And satya karta is the reason why, because of which all these sankalpa is causing the ajnanat prabhavam sarvam. So, vidrasham vicharaha is to be carried out. Now here, ajnanat prabhavam, this aspect is that this is the standard or the only route which Advaita says that is that everything sarvam is prabhavam is happening because of ajnana. Swarupa jnana nasti chet, jnanam nasti chet, sankalpa bhavati. We start thinking about, we start ideation or we start imagination about things. Just as a ghost is imagined on a post if there is no light, enough light to show the post as post. So that darkness or that jnana of the absence of correct knowledge from the light can give us a feeling that there is a ghost or somebody standing on the other side of the window of the door or the other side where we have a vision is darkening because we are not able to see it properly. Now, this is equated to seeing or the want of light is equated to ajnana. Swarupa jnanam vina. When you don't have the swarupa, swarupa is not only of our swarupa, sarvasya swarupa, swarupa of everything. That if we don't have, we start imagining things on that, and that is the what will create the world. If we really look at the world, I'm just slightly deviating from the meaning given in the Deepika to explain it more from the practical today's point of view. The objects per se are always available as it is. I've told this in the earlier class also. The object has a swarupa. And that swarupa can never change. What changes is not the swarupa, but what we superimpose on that object. Now, if a sweet is sweet, the sweet is liked or disliked will decide
whether that is a desired object or not desired object, or that is a good or bad. So the good or bad of is a quality attributed by our imagination or the desire which we put on that object, whether it is good for me because of my health reasons or for my, you know, my taste reasons. Then the object is identified with the sankalpa, not with the swarupa as it is. Because if it is, if we know the swarupa, everybody should be knowing the swarupa of it as it is. Now, for example, nobody normally misunderstands fire. Everybody knows fire as fire. So there is no confusion in the case of fire. So every one of us say that it is made of heat and light. But when a fire of an insect, which is called a globe, I don't know what is in what is the word equivalent in other thing. We have
glowworm.
Glowworm, yes, glowworm. Now there is light from that insect also. So earlier days people used to think that is the cause for the fire. That is because of the ajnana of the swarupa of the worm. Because the worm was giving the glow, so people thought that is what is giving rise to fire everywhere. Wherever fire is there, they might have been a glow worm before that. So that was the thought process. But never did they know that swarupa of the glow worm is naturally an insect which doesn't have any fire on its body or anything. It neither does it burn anything nor can it create fire. But sankalpa, because of the sankalpa happened, because they identified between the fire which they saw with the worm, they thought the worm is the one reason for the fire to happen. Same way, in our day-to-day life, we also attribute that this person has caused me certain thing, or that person has caused me certain thing, or this event is the reason which I am thinking. Now, for example, especially in this COVID reason, the virus is being told for all the death. Now, how many deaths are really due to the virus, or how many are natural death? There is nobody making anything. Sometimes they add it, or sometimes they don't even include that. So it's all purely from that point of view, we can see that it's all what we desire to do, we do it. But we attribute it on everything outside. So this, all this is happening is because of ajnana. The right knowledge, why it is happening, or why are we not liking anything, or why are we disliking something, is not because the object has two aspects of it. It is our mind which has the two aspects. One is the jnana aspect, one is ajnana aspect. So if we know the right knowledge, we will use the object, any object in our world, for the purpose it is created by the nature. But if we have a ajnana in us, our desire takes over the ajnana, and the same object is used either for harming some people or for the benefit of some other purpose. So these type of variations which we do is because of ajnana. So ajnanat prabhavam sarvam. And what happens is, once you know that what is the real nature of the object, the purpose of which the object is being created in the nature, that will remove our ajnana, and we will not have the desire to do anything with other than that. The object will be used only for that purpose. So this type of vichara is required when we are doing this neti, where we say that, you know, our mind itself is creating sometimes. A gross example is that some sect of people we like, some sect of people we don't like. All these are all created because of which, you know, ajnana happens. At the end of it, everybody is made of the same blood and flesh, and
if somebody is eating meat or somebody is not eating meat should not be the reason by which we like a person or dislike a person. It is because of our likes and dislikes we say that person who is eating meat is not liked by me, or that person who is like meat, I can be friend with him. Whichever attitude we take is because of our sankalpa. And that sankalpa is coming out of ajnana. If we look at vijnana, ajnana removed by the jnana, that the world is a creation without any likes and dislikes, it is as it is. You know, the famous Prabhupada's Gita as it is, I remember that. So the world is as it is. But the world becomes likable or disliked because of our sankalpa. So that can only go if we know the swarupa, and for swarupa, vichara, jnana is required, and jnana can come only from vichara. Now, this explanation given by Muni, Vidyarna Muni, is based on those theories which were existing those days of his time. Tadeva koha mityetat nischaya nischitya idanim katamitam jatamatyasya nischaya kriyate tatra prithivyadi bhutani karyatvat swasva paramanubhyo jayamta iti tarkikebhyoho manyate. So paramanu, from the paramanu, swasva rupso paramanu, earth has got its own paramanu and fire has got its own paramanu. From this sankadam, so is what the gross bodies, prithivyadi, gross bodies are prevailing. So what prithivi, which we call it as earth, is the sankatam of and paramanu of the element of earth, not the earth. So there is a tanmatra rupam and what is called the gross rupam which we see. Tarkikaha tereho manyate, then karmanaha jayate iti mimamsaka. Those days mimamsakas used to be very forceful in their in the philosophy and the thing. They say that everything is born out of karma. The actions which is being done by us, vidhi nisheda, nitya naimittika, all these are the type in which they had divided the karma. Some karmana jayate. So from the karma is what is the creation, that is the cause for the birth or the body to be taken birth. Pradhanat eva iti sankhya. Now sankhya system says pradhanam, pradhana means purusha. Pradhana, purusha, prakriti. So pradhanat eva iti sankhya. So the atma tattvam is from the pradhana or the purusha. It is Sankhya. Sankhya Matam says that is a Pradhana, the Atma which is in Pradhana. And each body has separate Atma. It is not one. That is where the Sankhya differs from Advaita. Even though there are so many similarities between Sankhya and Advaita. But where main difference is, the Purusha is many in the case of Sankhya, whereas Advaita says there is only one Atma. And Sa Atma, Sa Brahma. That is Atma and that is Brahma. Tatetat nirakuryan aha ajnaneti. For all this is the reason is called ajnana. Sarvam jagatitam nama rupatmakam ajnana prabhavam ajnanat purvoktat swatswarupa aspuranat prabhavati tadavitam ata eva eta virodina jnanena swaswas rupa spuranena tama iva prakashena praliyate nishesha leenam bhavati ityartha. So this is what I explained, this ajnana prabhavan jagatitam. The entire jagat is a jagat. What we call it is not what the objects per se, but here what we call is nama rupatmakam. So the nama and rupa is not there in the jagat before we put it. But we deal it with a nama and rupa, and because of nama rupa, ajnana prabhavam. Then the consequences of giving nama rupa is what we call it as today as the Jagat. That can only be Tama Iva Prakashena Praliyate. Just as the darkness gets dissolved in light. Actually speaking, darkness is not an object to get avastu asti. Darkness is not a vastu to praliyam, praliyate. Nishesha leenam bhavati. It doesn't take a leena, laya in the prakasha. But like it appears as if the darkness has molten and become null with in the prakasha. Same way, jnana comes when we look back, where did the ajnana which was confusing and giving ideation or imagination to me, where did it go? Where did the ghost go when the light came and I knew the post? The Trikala Bhaditam, there was no ghost even all the three times, before, during and after. But ajnana creates the awareness of a ghost in that dark, in the darkness, as a, in the, on the post, superimposed on the post. So jnanena praviliyate, the moment you get prakasha comes there, there was never a ghost, but we will think, where did the ghost disappear? Same way, the right knowledge, when it dawns on us, what is the mama surupam, koham, kahamitam jatam, all these answers then will be answered when you have the right knowledge or by right jnana comes in. So once that happens, all those questions which we are doing, that who am I, where am I coming from, or what is all this world about, what is my relationship with the world outside, all these things becomes of no questions at all. That it is not that it will be answered. That questions will not have an answer, because that questions were existing because we don't have the right knowledge. So koham is the question itself is a reason of, because of ajnana. So when we say that, but as long as ajnana says, we will have the question koham. Jnanena praviliyate. Kovai karta ityata ityasya nirnayam aha sankalpa iti vidito nana prakaraha sankalpaha iti karishyami ityadi lakshanottaha karana parimana parinamaha karana anukula vyaparan kaha ka shesham purvoktam. So purvoktam karanam. Anukula Vyaparam, Karanarukula Vyaparam. So all those Karana Sharira, Sushma Sharira, and all those Deha Pancha Sharira, with Dehatraya Vibhagam or Avastatraya Vibhagam, all these things, Jagat, that is what is called Jagat, Nama Rupatmagam. Now, where did it all that go? Then we know that it's all Sankalpa. That is the ultimate, you know, place where the vichara should land us with the proper thing. So when we analyze all those aspects, now in this one they talk about Kartika, Tarkika, Chavarbhaga, Mimamsaka and all those things. In today's world, we should look from the physics, chemistry, metaphysics, modern science, all those things. These Charvaka, Mimamsa are getting replaced by this modern science. They have their own meaning. It is not that they don't have a meaning, but they are not answering who am I or what is my relationship with the world. And Advaitin say it is Sankalpa, because for that, in the 16th sloka of the second Adhyaya of Bhagavad Gita, Nasate vidyate o bhavo, na bhavo vidyate sata. That Gita sloka, for that, Shankaracharya has given a beautiful commentary. It's a small book, paragraph, but it is loaded with meaning which can itself can run into 5 pages if somebody wants to explain it. Where he is explaining why, what is abhava, bhava, and so in that we will really know that how we have been confused about our own, you know, identity. And where do we, why do we get confused because of this is being explained. Now, we have 10 minutes. I don't think I can go to the next sloka. Any questions?
Mahodaya, what is the shloka once again, please?
16th shloka.
Nasato vidyate bhavo na bhavo vidyate tada.
Ubhayor api drishtontah dvanayos tatvadarshibhi. It's a beautiful.
In that,
Mahodaya, can you just give a brief of that shloka, which what Shankaracharya's commentary says, if you have time today?
I will just read the commentary today, but I can explain it only in the next class.
Okay, if it's possible. If you can just read out, I would like to hear, because that's a very important sloka also, and it has a lot of meaning for that. Mahodaya, we can't hear you, Mahodaya. Hari Om.
Hari Om.
No, I think yes.
Oh, astu. Okay, fine.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Okay. Na asataha vidyama avidyamanasya sitoshnadehe सकारणस्य न विद्यते नास्ति भावो भवनम् अस्ति अस्तिता. That is the opening statement of the this. नहि शीतोष्णादि सकारणम् प्रमाणो निरूप्यमानम् वस्तु सद्भवति विकारो हि सह विकारश्च व्यभिचरति. Right. यदा गडादि संस्थानम् चक्षुषा निरूप्यमानम् मृद व्यतिकरणानु उपलब्धेरन् विकारः करण व्यतिकरणेन व्यतिरेकानु करण व्यतिरेकानु अनुपलब्धेरन् जन्म प्रध्वंसाभ्याम् प्रागूर्ध्वं च अनुपलब्धे कार्यस्य गतादे मृतादि कारणस्य च तत्कारण व्यतिरेकेण अनुलब्ध रसत्वं लब्धे रसत्वं प्रतिकरणानु. I'll let us split the thing. See, here he is talking about what is sat and asat. Yat vishaya buddhir na vyapicharati tat sat. यद् विषया व्यभिचरति तद् असत् इति सदसत् विभागोः बुद्धि तन्मात्रो स्थिते सर्वत्र द्वे बुद्धि सर्वै रूपलभ्यते समानाधिकरणेन नीलोल्पलवत्. दिस् वन् सेण्टेन्स् इस् द वन् विच् इस् बीङ्ग् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् इन् फैव् पेजस् आर् सिक्स् पेजस् इन् द भाष्यकार बै आनन्दगिरि. Yet Vishaya Buddhirna Vyapacharati. In the Buddhi, what object is not changing, Tat Sat. Yet Vishaya Vyapacharati Tad Asat. Now, for Vyapacharam or for the deviation, he is making a differentiation. Sat Asat Vibhagaha. Buddhi Tat. तंत्रे स्थिते बुद्धि तंत्रे स्थिते. सो हियर सर्वत्र द्वे बुद्धि सर्वै रूपलभ्यते. ऑलवेज देयर इज अ टू टाइप ऑफ
identification which is happening, sat and asat, asti nasti. This is always our thoughts in the waking. Either we'll say asti or we'll say nasti. So that is the sat and asat. Now, for that he is using that samana adhigarane na nilotpadavat. San gadaha, san padaha, san hasti iti, evam sarvatra tayor buddheo, gadadi buddhi vyabhijarati. So, samanadhikaranam, he says there are three types. One is vastu samanadhikaranam, shabda samanadhikaranam, buddhi samanadhikaranam. So, if to understand that, in the vastu samanadhikaranam means if in a on a surface, if there are two objects, adhikaranam is saman, adhikaranam is ekam, the two objects are on that adhikaranam, so samana adhikaranyam is on the objects. So there are two vastus on the samana adhikaranyam. Suppose the teacher and the student is sitting in the same class, the teacher and student together is called samanadhikaranyam of the classroom. Same way, shabdam, san gataha, san padaha, san hasti. So, san here is sat iti pratipatikam, so it is pullinga san. San gataha, san padaha, san hasti. In that, pada, gada, hasti is changing, but san is not changing. So, san is the samanadhikaranam on which gada, pada, hasti, aja, gaja, all those things are we experienced on the sat. That we say that gajaha asti, ajaha asti, gadaha asti. So, on the astitvam, the objects are changing. So, samanadhikaranyam is on the objects, the adhikaranam of all the objects is sat. Same way, when we are hearing the samanadhikaranyam of the gaja, aja, pata and all those things, the buddhi or the knowledge of the objects are changing, but buddhi is not changing. The adhikaranam or the jnanam in which the objects appear are changing. The jnanam as what it is as an adhikaranam is not changing. I had explained this in one of my other classes where I said, no, just as we see objects with light, we don't see the light. The objects are changing because we are seeing the object as different from light. But without light, even the objects may be present there, that has no meaning to us, or the object there is the unification of all the objects in the darkness. So, same way the knowledge is the one in awareness in which the objects are appearing. Objects per se are changing, but objects all, when they are, even though when they are changing, we are calling it as sat, as that is, this is the pot, this is the elephant, this is the table, this is the chair, this is that asittum or the existential aspect of the objects are never changing. Objects per se are changing. So, this is used in the saying that na sato vidyate bhavo, na bhavo vidyate sada. So, why, what is that happening is that we are thinking there things are coming and things are destroying, getting destroyed. But what the shloka says is that there is neither the creation nor the destruction of anything. Both times it is our ajnana, from the point of ajnana that it, this appearance and disappearances take place. But vastutaha adhigaranatvena buddhe jnane na praviliyante. They don't get leanam from the jnana point of view. So, I mean, it's quite a long read. I don't think I can read it fully today. Maybe we'll have to keep one class for that alone.
No problem, Mahodaya. No problem.
Yeah. But it is one of the most important sloka of Bhagavad Gita, which Shankaracharya has taken so much of
effort to explain deviating from the Gita, what you call, background. He has gone into full of philosophy into that sloka. Same is, which in a different way is told in this sloka with Vidyaranya's commentary. How, why the Ajnana is making so much of confusion for us and we are not getting the right knowledge. So for that the Vichara is the only marga, and how the Vichara has to be done is being explained in this. So that particular Gita Bhashyam alone we will discuss in one of the classes. I'll get prepared so that I can prepare the slide and show it to you also.
And regarding this, all this Charvaka and other religions, in Shankaracharya, Purva Samitaya Uttam, before starting this Brahma Sutra,
yeah.
One the introduction is there, no? Samitaya, etat Sarvani Mata Vishye, Samitaya Uttam.
Yeah. Yushmat Asmat Pratyego Triyo Vishay Vishivino, Tama Prakashavat Virudha Swabhava Yoho. That is how we start the Shankara Bhashyam for the Brahma Sutra.
Guru Parananda Astakaluji. Guru Parananda, huh? It was taken by Guru Parananda. Nearly 36 episodes. 36
hours. Okay,
thank you,
sir. Okay, so any questions on this or?
Madhya, on the 13th sloka.
Right.
Akshagana and Bhutgana, they make it different. But the indriyas are not part of our body or Bhutgana. Cannot we say it's really sub part of Bhutgana? Why it is they have made it the two different stuff?
Now, indriyas are supposed to be represented by devas of each of the Bhutgana. For example, Tejo Maya Akshu, the eyes are supposed to be made from the same element of light. And the Vak, the power, the indriya of speech, not the tongue, please remember that. When we say Vak, it is not the tongue, it's a shabd, speech indriya. That is. That the devata of that is called Agni, Tejomaya, Agnimayam, then Karna, Vayumayam, Vayavya. So the sound, the devata for the ears are the from the Vayu, Akashavan. So like that, each Indriya has been got a respective Bhutagana from the Panchabhutas. That is the reason why they have got Indriya Bhutaganas and Indriya Ganas are separately shown. That one is a gross one is a subtle one. The Indriya Ganas are the subtle forms of it.
Oh, good.
But they want to cover both the subtle and the gross aspect of it. That's why.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll stop today's class here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Sarvebhyo Namaskara.